4 years later, December 1942.
As Dr. Frick, the German Minister of Interior, told the people last Sunday, the decision now must come by force of arms.
We'll expect to hear about air attacks on an even greater scale, with wave after wave of bombers roaring over the English, Scottish, and Welsh countryside, seeking to destroy all life.
German aircraft carried out a number of attacks on Great Britain last night. The raids, which lasted for several hours, were scattered over many parts of the country.
The United States has been attacked. The United States is in danger. Let every patriot take his stand on the bastions of democracy. We go into battle in defense of our own land.
Enough.
I want to know what's happening in Naples.
What's more to know?
I mean, what'll happen next?
Didn't you used to say war journalism is the most boring job possible? That it's all which ship is where and absolutely no nuance?
It doesn't stop it from determining the fate of the whole world. Besides, it's only boring if you're on the home front.
Don't you have tips on these things? Don't people from the journal call you? Why do you have to listen to the radio?
I don't know. It's nice to have it narrated. It helps it make sense.
Go work for radio, then. I want some peace and quiet.
Don't you want to hear about what...
You're not reporting on that.
At the journal, we get to...
But it doesn't sell like the war. That's what you said.
We might hear something.
Please, enough. It's Hanukkah. Enough. I forgot to mention, I got a letter today.
From who?
Lev. He's in training somewhere in Illinois.
When is he going out?
He doesn't know.
Does he like training?
No. He sounds pretty miserable. But of course, he's excited to go. He's always been an idiot.
Everyone thought his Divide Cora was excellent.
That's because you wrote it.
Assisted.
He should be lucky there's a war. He's too stupid to do anything else but work in the deli.
He'll be all right.
It was selfish of him. Like, my ma doesn't have enough to worry about.
He would have been drafted anyway.
I don't understand how someone can choose to go over there. To just walk into their jaws. If the Germans get him and they find out he's Jewish...
You don't even know what theater he'll go to.
They try to recruit Jews, you know? Write a story on that. They target us.
You don't know that.
How many boys from our shul alone have shipped out?
Half of that's been the draft.
Boys turn 18 and walk down to the recruitment office.
It isn't hard. I mean, you can't hear about what's going on over there and not want to help.
The narrative is all laid out. I mean, look at it. It's so easy. Every holiday is about just this. Someone tried to kill us all, but we were brave and fought back. God intervened, and then we didn't die. Mazel tov, let's eat. They must think they're the Maccabees.
Imagine Lev in ancient Greece.
Oh, stop.
Lev in a toga.
You look like a circus clown.
I don't know what I'd be doing then. Certainly not fighting with the Maccabees.
You'd be the one writing it all down. You'd be the reason we can remember.
That's a flattering spin on cowering on the sidelines.
You've never cowered. Of course, I'd be back in some tent lying on my back, waiting to have my fifth son at age 20.
Oh, that's not true.
Yeah? What else would I be doing?
You'd certainly be off telling everyone they're making the wrong choices. They'd review you as a prophetess.
Or burn me as a witch.
You're feeling snippy.
I just don't find this that funny.
You're making it deeper than it is.
We don't know if God will come down on our side for this one.
Neither did they.
They also must have thought it was the end of the world, I guess.
Same at the fall of Rome, and during the Inquisition, or when we lost the temple.
Wasn't it, though?
What do you mean?
I mean, people who died then, they must have thought they died at the end of the world. that the damage was irreparable.
But it wasn't. The world kept turning.
But not for them. I mean, the world always... That's not what I mean. Fundamentally, the world had changed forever. Things can be marked with a before and after. That's sort of the end of the world, right? At least the end of their worlds?
Is that comforting, then? To know that people have been here before, but wasn't the end?
I don't know. Would you want to live during the Spanish Inquisition?
No, of course not.
And why is that?
Because I would end up tortured to death or burned at the stake. Probably the grisliest ways to go I can think of.
Are you sure you wouldn't just change your name and hide? But, exactly. And that was the reality for, I don't know, thousands of people. So it's like, even if this isn't the end of the world, how many more people have to die before it's over? And how much are we going to lose? And still, I mean, this also could just be the end. We really don't know.
Have you heard anything from your mother lately?
About?
Cousins.
Over there?
Yeah.
No. I'd tell you if I did. And your mother?
Nothing. For ages.
It makes me feel ill.
Me too.
It's so stupid to even expect news, because obviously...
Well, not obviously.
Why not?
They could be in hiding. They could be somewhere they can't afford to get contact.
The last we heard from anyone was Sam and his wife. And that was in June.
I know.
They arrested Paris's Jews in July.
He said they were trying to cross the channel.
But that it looked pretty impossible.
Do you want him to be dead?
No, of course not.
Then why is it every time we have this conversation, I feel like you've killed them all off in your head already?
Because I have no reason to hope that they're alive. I don't understand how you do.
People are escaping. We interviewed someone at the Journal just last week. A young woman from Munich. I wanted to ask her if she knew, but it was too frightening.
Of course it was. You already know the answer.
That isn't true.
Then why didn't you ask? You understand my point. I didn't see that interview. When are you publishing it?
The editor axed it.
Why? It seems like it would sell.
The girl. She got here illegally. They didn't want to condone it.
Ah.
Besides, he said it makes us sound like too much of a Jew paper. I said I'd take my name off it. That would convince them to run it. Give someone else the credit, but he didn't care. The official reason was that it veered too much into sensationalism, which was just complete horseshit. I mean, what was I sensationalizing? It's just true.
Is she all right?
The girl? Yeah. She's staying with an aunt in Chicago now. I don't think anyone will come after her.
You don't really know, though.
No. I guess I don't. But she... Well, she reminded me of you. She was tough. She understands how to survive.
If I was over there, I don't know if I would be surviving. I think I'd just feel paralyzed. A girl I knew when I was an undergraduate. She went to Prague some years ago to work. No one's heard from her since. She's American, Ezra.
I'm glad you never took work over there.
I was never good enough to get it. Probably a blessing now.
I often wonder what I'd do. If they came here. don't think I'd be a hero.
You're such an idiot. You probably would.
But how? I mean, what does dying even do? You read that what? 1,000 of us are shot in one day in Poland? I mean, how can any death mean anything with that just senseless loss of life?
I thought those reports are unconfirmed.
That's what they tell us to say. And they bury them under other stories. I don't know why we have correspondents over there. They know that this is happening. It's obvious. But every single story, unconfirmed, alleged, possible, the State Department denies. It's like they want them to disappear. I tell them, all right, let me write about what's happening here then. Let me write about the Klan. Let me write about American fascists. But that's, well, that's impeding the war effort. We need national unity. So most of those get axed too.
But you keep writing those stories. You're getting them printed.
There's nothing of use for me to do over here anymore.
Enough of this. I'm going to be sick.
It'd be tragic if you couldn't keep down those latkes.
Let's put on some music.
What is this?
Tosca. Recorded in Rome in 1938. I've been meaning to catch it, but you've been hogging the radio.
Tosca is... Verdi... No, you told me this. Puccini.
Yes.
I presume a beautiful young woman dies of consumption or something of the sort.
Something of the sort.
What's happening now?
The corrupt official is torturing her lover, so that she'll make love to him instead.
Ah.
Ruth painted the sets when we did Tosca. I was in the chorus.
When is she getting here?
I don't know. Soon. But the snow's coming down thick. The trains are messed up. And she's coming from Queens.
Practically a world away.
I hope she at least catches the tail end. We wanted to listen to it together.
I'm excited to meet her.
You'll like her, I think.
Would it matter if I didn't?
Not really.
I hope she cooked. The latkes smell like shit.
Hey!
What? They're certainly not your mother's.
Maybe if you'd been of any help.
They kept me late at work.
Typical.
That you shouldn't have even attempted. We should have ordered from a deli or something.
Yes, but now I can call my mother tonight and tell her how I cooked latkes for you, and she'll smile and sleep easily knowing that the Jewish home is being upheld.
Your two outcast cousins make up the Jewish home.
You've not been an outcast in years. Ruth can cook less than me. Her mother died having her. No one even taught her the basics.
My God, what will you two do?
I don't know. Live on eggs and sandwiches?
You can do a lot with that.
I suppose. How did you and Julia get by? She couldn't cook, right?
I don't know. We could each make a few good things. We rotated those.
Maybe we'll hire a cook.
When you're an opera star. Or a famous composer.
I want to live near Washington Square Park. In one of those beautiful buildings you see. Like by the Cooper Union.
I thought you'd want to live uptown. By the Met.
I feel like I'm in a different country when I go that far uptown. Like, I need to have my passport out. I couldn't live there. Besides, there's no good delis, and it would take nearly 2 hours to get to Crown Heights by train.
Does Ruth like Queens?
It's inconvenient, but it's what she can afford. She's excited to come live here. Better location.
And what have you told the family?
That she's my roommate. I've had roommates before. It's not a big deal.
I hope you know what you're doing.
I do.
It's sort of disturbing, isn't it? The music? It's not very pretty.
No, it's not, but that isn't the point.
I guess you just think of operas as being beautiful.
That's why this one is so good. I'd love to sing her, but I don't have the range.
Maybe someday.
It doesn't work like that. You don't get it. You know, it's embarrassing you don't have a girl of your own at this point.
You sound like my mother.
Oh, believe me, I hear it. Your mother keeps telling my mother to tell me to introduce you to any nice girls I know.
Christ.
You should be worried. If this was the old country, they'd have brought out the Yenta by now.
I don't get it. I'm not an old man, and they're not afraid that I'm a queer, so what's the rush?
They're afraid you'll date another Shiksa.
I'll tell them not to worry.
My mother thinks you're bringing home lady reporters from the Journal every night because Max Goldstein thought he saw you in Central Park with some blonde girl, and now all the aunts are talking about it.
That's ridiculous.
I told them that.
I haven't been to Central Park in ages.
I know.
There's no one at my work. Tell your mother that. And also, tell her if she wants to talk about these things, she can talk to me. She can just call me.
You know how they are. They need to feel like secret agents about the whole thing.
Do they not trust you? Or do they think you're lying for me or something?
I mean, you lie for me.
That's different. The stakes are higher.
I could set you up if you want. You know, some girl at shul.
I don't want that. You know, when I came down for the High Holy Days, she seemed to introduce me to about 15 different girls.
You should have seen the guys they paraded in front of me. But that's far more desperate. If I'm not engaged sooner rather than later, people might start to wonder.
They'll get over it.
I know. But I'm in a window when I'm too young to be an old maid, but too old to be unmarried. Once I turn 30, they'll stop caring. Or, well, it'll be less dire.
If it was the old country, they'd have just married us to each other.
Oh, can you imagine?
Quite well. You'd kill me in my sleep.
You don't think I could be a good wife to you? What have I been these past few years?
A pain in the ass. What does Ruth's family think?
It's just her father. He's the only one who came over. I'm not really sure. I think he knows, though.
Really?
Yeah. Not knows. I doubt they discuss it, but I think it's sort of been accepted as inevitable.
He was born over there.
Yeah, he's from Berlin. They were more cosmopolitan there, though. It makes sense in a way.
Her family over there.
We don't discuss it.
Her poor father.
I know.
God, you'd think we had nothing else to talk about.
Do you want to put the news back on?
No. I like this. It's good.
All right.
Invite me the next time you're performing or your work gets performed.
Yeah. That's the time before that happens.
You don't know that.
People aren't really in the mood for Tosca right now. Present company excluded.
Don't people want to forget their troubles?
Is this making you forget your troubles?
Not all opera has to be tragedy. You could write a comedy, couldn't you?
I don't think I have the stomach for that right now. I don't want to make people laugh. If I wrote an opera today, it would be all minor, all dissonant, all off tempo. It would have no discernible melody and be awful to listen to.
Well, I'd give it a listen.
You're sweet.
I feel it too. I can't seem to write about anything else. And when I do write about this, my editor says I'm too emotional, too personal. It makes for purple prose, and I've lost the rational voice he hired me for. I mean, I don't know. I think what I'm writing is... Well, I'm proud of it, because I'm not trying to be anything else anymore. But I know what he means. It's like something's eating away at me.
I don't know how anyone expects us to just go through things day to day.
I mean, you know, we're doing it.
That doesn't mean it's easy. You can do lots of things that are impossible. I think that must be her.
You think she's okay?
I don't know. I bet the trains have gone down and she's stuck in a phone booth.
I could drive to pick her up.
Maybe. Hello? Oh. Outside?
Who is it?
No, we're not busy. Are you all right? We're just getting ready for Hanukkah. Yes, he's here. Yes, first night. I mean...
Who is it?
Yes, it's very strange. No, I'm not saying you can't come up. Just give me a minute to think.
Who is it?
It's Julia.
What's she doing here?
She said she was in town.
She's in town and just happened to stop by?
I don't know.
What's wrong with her?
She sounds urgent.
Okay, so what?
She came all this way.
I don't want to see her.
You're being a baby. It's been 4 years.
Tell her to go away.
It's snowing. At least let her warm up.
She can go to a diner and warm up there.
I'm sorry, we're just discussing. It's been 4 years. You don't even want to know how she is.
No, I want her to go away.
You're shaking.
I'm fine. I just want her to go away.
I'm letting her up.
Are you serious?
Just to warm up, just to call her a cab.
Call her a cab from here.
You're being rude.
He's being rude. He just showed up unannounced.
Come on up.
This is evil of you.
Okay, I'm evil. You haven't spoken to her in 4 years. This is probably good for you. Besides, I'm curious. I mean, she came all this way. She must have a reason.
She's engaged.
Who told you that?
A friend who used to work at the Globe heard she was. Someone from Newport or something.
Oh.
So I don't know why she could possibly be here. Do you think he was with her?
No. She said she was alone. And I couldn't hear anyone else.
I don't understand why she's doing this.
Why don't you ask her?
I'm going for a walk.
Ezra!
You can invite her up. Fine. It's your apartment. But I don't have to see her.
She obviously wants to see you.
Tough luck.
What do I tell her?
To go to hell.
You're gonna catch your death of cold.
All right, then.
I couldn't just turn her away.
Why? Why do you suddenly care about social graces?
Because it's Julia. If you're really so desperate to not see her... Call before you get back, so I'll tell her to leave before you come up.
Thank you.
Take your scarf.
I will.
The End of the World was written and directed by Zoe Senese-Grossberg. It was sound designed and edited by Remy Gajewski and stage managed by Isabelle Pflanz. Starring Sophie Falvey, Katie Friedemann, and Justin Pelofsky. I'm your host, Jack Brimm.